this video, we will talk about array lists and linked lists in Java. What's common between them? What's the difference between them? And when and why use linked list versus array list? My name is Ali. I do videos every week. So if you like my videos and content, and if you are new to my channel, just subscribe to get notified when a new video and content gets released. And don't forget to give me a thumbs up so I can keep continue on producing this content for you. Before we start, go ahead and join our Discord server and be part of the great developers community that we are building. Both of linked list and array list, they implement the list interface. So both of them, they implement the same methods like get, size, isEmpty, and so on and so forth. Both of these objects support the same exact method. This means if you want to change or migrate from an array list to a linked list, it will be an easy task and you won't need to change any other code because we have the same exact methods in both of them.
Excuse me, but if both of them implement the exact same methods, so who cares which one I use?
Really good question. The main difference between these two objects comes in the way they are implemented. And choosing one over the other may impact the performance of your application.
Are you serious? Is it that important?
Yes, exactly. So first, let me tell you how an array list is implemented. An array list uses an array as an underlying data structure. You can create an array and give it a fixed size. As you know, in Java, array sizes are fixed. If you want to insert a new element in the array and have a bigger size, you need to create a new array, insert the old element and the new element in it. So an array is doing all this behind the scenes. If a new element needs to be inserted, a new array with bigger size will be created and all the elements will be migrated to this new array. But all this work comes with a price. The resizing can be a bit of time and resources consuming. Let me now explain how linked lists work. Instead of an array, we have a bunch of elements called nodes, and each node is linked to the next node, and together they form a linked list. So the linked list starts with a pointer pointing to the first element, and each element or node is pointing to the next one. You can also have a doubled linked list, meaning each element is pointing to the previous and to the next element at the same time. And this is how linked lists are implemented in Java. Imagine now you want to get an element of your list. Imagine we want, for example, to get the element number 9. Now let me explain to you how behind the scenes a linked list or an array list are capable of retrieving this element. Array list has what we call random access. So to get an element, all we need to do is to provide the index, and this will take the same amount of time to read the data. It's the same amount of time to get the first element as it's the same amount of time to get the last element. In linked list, it's way different because Java doesn't start in a reference in between and just grab the element. So it starts whether from the beginning or the end of the list, and it has to go to each element of the list and check if this is the required element or not. And once it's found, it will be returned. This operation is way slower in comparing to array list. The performance of a linked list comes when we want to insert or to remove an element. So Java will start from the beginning of the list until it finds the required elements. And all we need to do is to change the references. All we need to do is updating the indexes and the pointers of the element that we want to insert or the element that we want to remove. For an array list, Java has to create a brand new array, copy all the old elements, and leaving an empty spot for the new element that you want to insert, and then insert it. And this operation, as I mentioned, is a costly operation.
Can you tell me when to use an array list and when to use a linked list?
The answer is when it comes to sorting and accessing data, it's very recommended to use array lists. But when it comes to manipulating the data, it's more recommended to use linked lists. If you like the video and if you like this new concept, just go ahead and subscribe to my channel, share this video, and comment what's the next topic you want me to teach you. Thank you for watching and see you next time.